Hello out there, my name is Benjamin, and thank you so much for joining me here in the studios of Blaben Solutions. In this very video, I will be taking you through a step-by-step, with no steps skipped, on how to design this wonderful church flyer. Before I begin, let me use this platform to say a very big thanks to all frontline health workers across the globe, especially my country Ghana, who are working tirelessly hard to fight coronavirus. You risk your lives to save others. We have nothing to replenish this act of genuine love demonstrated by you all, but all we can say is Ayiko, and may the good Lord continue to bless you. With this being said and done, let's quickly get started. So I already have my Photoshop application opened, and there's my Photoshop application, and there's the interface. So what I'm going to do first is I'm going to create a new working space, and to do that I will come to the file tab, click here, click new, and I believe by now you know your way out in here. So the title is going to be something like church flyer, and I'm going to change the unit of measurement into pixels. I'm going to go by 1920 to 1080. Alright, so when make sure the resolution is at 300 pixels per inch, and I think everything is okay here. So we're going to click OK, and this is our workspace. So the first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to change the background color by adding a solid color fill. So to do that, I'm going to come in here and I'm going to click this, and I'm going to add a solid color. So the solid color is going to be something like, let me see, something like this. Okay, so that is it. So what I'm going to do next is I'm going to import an image to fill the background in here. So I have my resources in here, and these are my resources. So I'm going to import this image here, so to my Photoshop, and I'll leave this in here like this. So I'm going to right click and rotate this to the other side, that is horizontally rotating this. So I want this here like this, and I'm going to duplicate this image actually. So I'm going to push this a bit here like this, and I'm going to zoom this up a bit. So something like this is okay. I'm going to hit enter, and I'm going to duplicate this image. So to do that, I'm going to press Ctrl J on my keyboard, and I'm going to press Ctrl T, and I'm going to right click, and I'm going to rotate this version. So I'm going to hold my shift key, and I'll drag this so that it moves straight in a straight line. So we have something in here like this. Alright, so what I'm going to do is I'm going to hold this portion, select both images, and I'm going to merge them together. So to select both images, make sure you hold your shift key and you press the other. So right click, and I'm going to merge these layers together to one solid layer. Now I can move this layer anywhere like this. That is it. So Ctrl Z to place it right. Alright, so now the next thing I'm going to do is I'm going to come onto the color mode in here, the blending mode. I'm going to choose darken, and I like something like this. So what I'm going to do now is I'm going to import another image, that is a sky image, and I have the image in here, so I have something like this, blue skies, and I'm going to import this image in here. So I'm going to leave this onto this portion like this. So I'll make sure to scale this image large enough to cover the entire canvas. So I'm going to hold shift and drag this up a bit, something like this, and I think this is okay. So I'm going to hit enter. Alright, so now the next thing I'm going to do is I'm going to come onto my blending mode in here. And I'm going to change this to soft light. Something like this is okay. So now the next thing I'm going to do is I'm going to create some shapes layers in here. And I will import the images and clip match them onto the shape. So I'm going to first of all create a shape of white background fill. And something like this. I think something like this is okay. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to press Ctrl T and I'm going to right click. I'm going to choose skew, right? So I'm going to just turn this something like this. And I think this is okay. So let me go a little bit more. And I'm going to duplicate this to get. So let me resize this to something like this. I'm going to duplicate this. So to duplicate, I'm going to press Ctrl J on my keyboard, and I'm going to duplicate one more, Ctrl J, and something like this. So we have something like this. Right. So I'm going to press R3 by holding Shift, and I can move them anywhere that I want to move them onto. I'm going to put these guys in here like this. Right. Now, so what I'm going to do next is I'm going to import the images and I'll click match them onto each of these shapes in here. So I have three images. Let me do that. This portion, and I'm going to hold and drag this. Here like this. And I'll make sure I bring it on top of the shape. Ctrl T to rescale this. So I'm going to right click here and I'm going to create a clipping mask. So I have something like this. So I'm going to do same for the next other two shapes. So I'm going to fast forward this portion and I'll get back to you soon. Alright guys, so the next thing I'm going to do in here is I'm going to do typing, and let me begin. So I'm going to select my type tool in here and I'm going to click anywhere in the canvas area here. So I have something like this in here. So I'm going to type "This will be done," and let me change the font color to white so that we can have a clear view. This will be done. Association. Sorry about that. International. I'm going to shift this here like this, and I'm going to change the font type to Mirite Pro, and I'm going to reduce the size to something like 11. Okay, so now the next thing I'm going to do is I'm going to continue in the typing, and I'm going to fast forward this portion so as to save time, and I'll get back to you guys shortly. So see you. Alright guys, so this brings us to the end of the typing, and what I'm going to do next in here is I'm going to import a logo, and I'm going to place a logo in here. So I have my my logo here like this. So this is the logo. So I'm just going to hold and drag this, and I'm going to bring this in here like this. So Control T, and I'm going to scale this to the size that I want. I'm going to hold this and I'm going to drag this up a bit. I'm going to scale it again. So I think this is okay. Then I'm going to hit enter, and there you have it. Our flyer is ready to be printed. Alright guys, so this brings us to the end of today's video tutorial. If you really enjoyed, please don't forget to hit on the subscribe button, and also make sure to check the bell icon so as to be notified whenever we release new videos. Do well to like, share, and let me know your thoughts in the comment box below. Until I come your way next time, it is still Blaben Solutions, and see you in our next video. Thank you.